Oh, hello, you multi-mummified bodies. And thank you to Sandra in Cairo, yeah, for that malt mention. How appropriate. In fact, I was in Egypt a number of years ago, and they call Egypt the greatest outdoor museum in the world. And really, some of the temples, the pyramids, it's just extraordinary, absolutely extraordinary. I tell you what else is extraordinary. Another whiskey review here at alfie.com. Yes. Back to the now for whiskey review 405. And you are most welcome to spend the next 10 or so or slightly longer minutes here with me, Ralphie, as we share a quality Manx Bothy malt moment here in an obscure little corner of whiskey paradise. Yes, you have arrived, and we're about to share a rather good contender for the title of consistently good quality malt of the year. It's Balvenie, 15-year-old. I've known this whiskey for quite a number of years now. I've never been disappointed yet. Oh, that's a bit much, isn't it? I should have poured less. The thing is, when I know I'm pouring a good whiskey, life's too short and ain't no dress rehearsal. Therefore, if you know it's good, pour a little drop more and make it last longer. Right. Oh, beautiful. 15-year-old single cask Balvenie. This is cask 10778. It was distilled on the 12th of September 1997. Can you remember what you were doing in 1997? I can. I was working. And bottled on the 14th of March 2013. Can you remember what you were doing there? It's not that long ago. I can. I was having fun. And it's been bottled at 47.8%. And this has been a feature of Balvenie for quite a number of years now. It's rather similar in reputation to Aberlour Abernah, in that at a moment in time when malt fans around the world are increasingly looking to have a dependable malt to buy, when people are hoping to reproduce or recreate the caliber of experience from the previous bottle purchased. You know, some whiskies, the batches vary and it can cause quite a bit of disappointment. I really haven't had that problem with the likes of Balvenie. It's rather same, it's rather like a Annock, 16-year-old Annock, another consistent, dependable whiskey. And I've only just started tasting this. The reason I've not tasted much, by the way, is because it's just been small glasses up to now, because I'm going to keep this aside for a whiskey tasting and share it at one of my presentations, a little charity fundraising gig. And the benefit, of course, is because I've opened the bottle and reviewed it, I now know the quality of what I'm going to be presenting to the audience. That's good. Nose, spicy, fresh fruit, slightly raisiny, melon, ripe pear spiciness. Very, very good quality. A nice clarity of flavour. A lovely balanced engagement with oak casks. It hits the nose immediately. This is good stuff. Fresh fruit, vanilla malt, fresh oak, mocha, honey, and then some tropical fruits, pineapple, guava, then some spiciness. Slight herby spice with some caraway, very mild caraway seed, sandalwood, angelica, some floral notes of lilies, and with water, you get a softer green fruit of kiwi and gooseberry. If you're adding water, my recommendation is don't add much, just add a little. because this is a delicate whisky. Old versions of Balvenie can be superb. They can also be shockingly expensive, particularly if you're buying at auction. So buyer beware. All the character and complexity of a good Highland Park is, and what I'm tasting is a calibre of whisky which I took for granted 15 years ago, but I don't take for granted now, and I've got it in here. So excellent stuff, well traditionally matured. Really want to emphasise, this is a properly, we're not double matured here, this is, you know, a one cask going all the way, and if it has been transferred to a second cask, well, it has been done so for quite a while, because it doesn't have that double matured effect, if you know what I mean. Spicy fresh fruit, malt, barley, sugar, vanilla essence, banana, pineapple, fritters, mild oak, and with water, some rich vanilla, honey, ripe fruits with buttery citrus notes. Complex, lovely, delicious. And the finish, lemon citrus juice, complex citrus notes, vanilla, and mild measured oak. This is just a well-matured, fresh fruit, complex oak single, oaked, balanced oaked, single malt event. And I'm really enjoying it. 91 out of 100. That's a malt. A malt mark. Excellent. Something I'd like to add to this review is that the longer you spend with a whisky, the more rewarding it is. And one of the little features that I've identified exploring this whisky is after about 15 or so minutes, there was a fruit note appeared, which I've not encountered very often, just occasionally. But I've never encountered it quite as complex and as rounded as I have here. And it's tangerine. Tangerine, these little oval orangey fruits that have their own distinctive flavour. Well, latterly I've identified a tangerine note of oil, of the rind, of juice, of the whole tangerine, not just part of it, not just confectionery as you would get in a fruit drop out of a sweetie shop. You don't really get it on the nose. It's on the palate. And that, from my experience, tells me that you've got that little bit of added extra happening when the cask and the spirit being matured in the cask are in harmony and they're producing something else, something additional. Lovely little toasty notes in the finish. And a little label that tells us non-chill filtered. Even better. Does that look like it's had a lot of caramel added? No. That doesn't have an orange glow about it. That's got a nice soft peach stroke apricot natural colour to it. And have I got the price tag inside here? No, I haven't. I must have bought it with other whiskey. I do that frequently. Not too shockingly expensive either, for the quality you're getting. So there we are, Ralphie recommended. Doesn't get much better than that, does it, malt mates? And I'd like to conclude with one of my little typical routine pieces of advice. Now, you know, I haven't even thought what advice I'm going to give you, so this is right off the top of my head. And it actually takes me to a situation I had last week where I get stung by one of my bees because I'm a beekeeper. And what I've found is when you get stung by a bee late in the season when you're coming into winter, the venom is more intense because the bees build up the venom in the sting to defend the hive from predators, winter predators, who are after their winter stock of honey. Because without that winter stock of honey, they're not going to survive. So it's perfectly understandable. So, you know, I've got no issues with the bees. It was my own fault for not dressing up properly with proper protective wear before I started poking about and putting the mouse inhibitors on. But I got some antihistamine cream. And that evening, I noticed that my whiskey tasted different. Now, I've had this with steroid ointment, and now I've identified it with antihistamine cream and tablet, because I usually take a tablet, just one, with the antihistamine cream. If you are taking medication or are on medication, never forget that it can influence and affect not just what you taste and smell and change that, but also the degree of the intensity of your sense of smell and taste. And if we're a bit under the weather, it is a fact, a scientific fact, that the alertness of our senses can diminish. So we're not really tasting as clearly as we otherwise might be when we're in full normal health. So if you happen to be loaded with the cold, or a little bit sort of under the weather, or a little bit washed out from working long shifts and all the rest of it, and you're wondering why you're not quite enjoying your whiskey as much as you did when you were on holiday and relaxing and having a break, well, there's a very simple reason. You're not enjoying it as much because your senses aren't picking up as much information to translate into enjoyment. So be aware of that. Recognize it. I'm Ralphie, here to help with these additional important little malt moments. Thank you for watching. If you pop back again, do you know what? More malt whiskies. We're having a little prolonged series of malt whiskies. And then we'll do some basic blended stuff and then some basic malty stuff. Yep, especially for those on a budget. Thanks for watching. See you soon.